Hi, I'm Wendy with Nashville Restoration, and I hate sanding. So I'm going to show you how to distress a table with chalk paint without using sandpaper before, during, or after. I'm going to paint a little bit of this and then come back on the video when I have the first coat painted and start with tips on how to do this. I think the most important thing for me, distressing without sandpaper, is that I do not wait until the paint is all dry to do it. I like to do it as the paint dries. So we'll get the first coat on this and then come back and explain how to do it. Okay, so I pulled the top out so I wouldn't get paint on it, and I have a coat of paint on this. It is dry in that you can touch it and it's mostly dry, but it would not be dry enough to like put another coat on, and you wouldn't want to like rub your hand across it because there's probably some wet paint somewhere. So when figuring out when to distress, just so it's kind of dry, not all the way dry. This is the only type of rag that I use for this. It's a microfiber towel. I think a lot of people maybe use it on cars, but you can get them at department stores and auto stores. But I'm gonna take this, it's kind of damp. It's not sopping wet, but it's a little bit damp. And just like in the same manner you would sandpaper, you start to run it along where you would like to distress. Now this piece I have to do in two coats because it's kind of dark, so one coat's not gonna cover it. So I'm gonna do just like you would sandpaper, run along the edges. You can tell pretty quick whether you're taking off too much paint, and then also remember that you can always touch up the parts that you don't like. So like these edges, I kind of put my finger in there and run it along the edge, and it takes off the paint pretty quickly. A lot quicker than sandpaper would. Also, when you're painting with a brush, the areas that I'm going to distress, I might not put as much paint on because it just makes this easier later on. The other thing that the microfiber towel does is that when you run it across the surface like this, it smooths the paint out and gives it a little bit of a whitewashing effect because the rag is actually soaking up some of the paint as you distress, and it kind of spreads it around. So you can see how much easier this comes off. To me, it's a lot easier than sanding, and hate sandpaper. And if I do this, it means I can do it in the house without dust, and makes cleanup a lot easier. See, a lot came off right there, but I'll just come back with some white on that. It just wasn't, that's what happens when it's, there was more paint here, so it was not all the way dry, so it kind of came off in a piece. But no big deal, because we're distressing, and that means you just get it how you like it. These tables actually were a custom order, the pink and purple, a while back, and I ended up getting them back from the customer through a turn of events. They moved, and so they came back. This is the second time I've painted them. First time was years ago when they were this pink and purple. So I'm gonna keep working on this. Your paint is going to be, of course, is going to dry faster in the summer than in the winter. And also, if it's getting ready to rain, there's moisture in the air, it will take longer to dry. But you can tell pretty quick when you put your rag on here whether it's ready to distress. And then you can always put more paint on. So to me, it's worth experimenting to not have to deal with sandpaper. And since my shop does not have air conditioning, it's worth it to me to not have to be hot in the summer. I can just bring everything inside in the coolness and work on it. So I'm gonna finish doing this, and then I'm going to come back after I put, I'm gonna finish distressing this, and I'm gonna put a second coat of paint on, and I will be back with that shortly. So I waited about an hour after I distressed this coat, just so it would get, the rest of it would just get pretty dry. So on the second coat, when I come back, the parts that I like the way it looks already, I'm not gonna do anything to them. I'm gonna put paint in the areas where I think it needs paint. And then this just a little light. As I do the second coat, and really sometimes as I do the first, I will distress as I go with the damp rag. It's really easy to get, of course, wet paint up where you've just put it. So I do that quite often, actually. Dry brushing technique where most of your paint is out of your brush. I like that on a little bit too much pink and purple is showing through there. Also not afraid to use my hands. Here is pretty light, so, and I like the way the hardware looks, so I'm not going to do anything to that. Really is, there aren't really a lot of rules for distressing, so it's kind of like, do it how you want it, and there you go. I probably won't do much distressing after this dries. I'm going to do as much of it as I can as I go. And then obviously I'm not going to do this whole table on camera because it just takes longer than video will last. Just a little bit of paint there. One of my dogs took the other one's bone, so I'll be right back. I found it. This is the one that got his bone taken. There you go, buddy. I have four of those little dogs. Three Havanese and one Maltese. This is pretty much a dry brush. Got a little bit of paint on it. But when you do that, it kind of makes, dry brush kind of gives it a whitewash look. Go. So there we go. Distressing without sanding. Microfiber towel. I'll wax this when it's dry. So there you have it, how to distress without sanding, microfiber towel, and here it is. Check back for more videos, we've got a lot more coming up.